This is mine. This is mine. This is my worship journey. This is my worship journey.
Oh my goodness, what was the first song? Well, there was a particular song that my father's group used to sing. And one of the ministers would always lead the song. And then my father said, I'm going to take that song from them. I'm going to give it to the Jubilees. That's the name of the group we used to sing with, called the Gospel Jubilees. And the name of the song was Already Been to the Water. I remember singing that song. And when I started singing that song, all of a sudden, I didn't know what it was. I said, I just felt different. And then I started raising my hands. And next thing I know, I just started shouting. That song brought joy to my life. Already Been to the Water. And that was actually about 7 years after I was baptized. And so it reminded me of how I was baptized in the red, muddy water in Southeast D.C. Already been to the water, already been baptized, already been converted, and I feel all right. Ever since I've given up sin, hallelujah, I've been born again. Thank you.
Yeah. catches.
How old was I when I first started singing? I was 5 years old. I was given a solo to sing for Christmas. And I was absolutely, positively terrified. And so Sister Jameson was the music director. That's a shame. That I remember that. It's 53 years ago, and I still remember that. Sister Jameson had coached me up to get me ready to sing for Christmas. And I was so afraid. I was so afraid. So afraid that I told Sister Jameson, I said, we're going to be out of town during Christmas, so I'm not going to be able to do my solo. And she said, oh, Alan, I'm so sorry to hear about that. I said, yes, ma'am, I'm sorry too. So perhaps you can find someone else to take my solo. So a day or two went by, and Sister Jameson ran into my mama. And Sister Jameson said, Phyllis, I'm so sorry that Alan's not going to be able to sing his solo. My mama said, what? She said, yeah, Alan told me that you all are going out of town for Christmas. And she said, we're not going nowhere out of town for Christmas. Wait till I see him. So when my mother caught up with me, and she didn't spank me, but she said, why did you tell that lie? I said, Mama, I'm afraid. I'm afraid to sing in front of all those people. And it was my mama who coached me up. And it was my mama who gave me the confidence to sing. To sing that solo that Christmas day. And I did. And so many people told me so many wonderful things about me singing. But the song that really became a rites of passage for me was when I turned 12 years old. I was in the seventh grade in Long Island, New York. And Sister Wilson said, boy, I want you to learn this song, James Cleveland song. I said, yes, ma'am, because we were terrified of Sister Wilson. Sister Wilson, both of my fingers, well, that was one of her fingers. She had these huge fingers, but she could play that piano like nobody's business. So we were a little terrified of Sister Wilson. But nonetheless, she taught me this song. Take a look.
And the stars, the fields full of grain, the soft summer breezes, the mild autumn rain,
they all belong.
At play on the street every day, the mother that kneels at midnight to pray.
He sits high
and he looks low
and he
laughter and his medicine too. Or the lawyer who pleads your case for you.
This is a good one. My favorite song to sing is You Are Jehovah. It was some years ago, and I was at a conference called The Gathering with Pastor Cassandra Elliott, and she'd introduced me to this album. And one of the songs on the album was You Are Jehovah. And I remember just being in a broken place. And this song just spoke to me on so many levels. Not only were the lyrics just absolutely amazing and were able to pull me out of the space that I was in, but the beat was hot. I was like, wait, man. I loved everything about it. So not only is it my favorite song to listen to, it's also my favorite song to sing because it jams. You Are Jehovah.
Come on and put those hands together. Hey, hey, let's go. Say na 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 na,
na, na, na, na.
Everybody clapping. Na 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 na.
Na, na.
Say everybody clapping.
Jehovah,
and I glorify.
Hey,
there is no other.
Wow. Who influenced me? Okay. Well, I was a child of the Motown era, so Diana Ross and Tammy Terrell were big for me. And then, of course, there was Aretha Franklin and Chaka Khan. And then I fell in love with the voices of people like Barbara Streisand and Phoebe Snow. Okay, The Ring Fell Down the Drain and The Poetry Man, oh my gosh. And I loved Sandy Patty, but I could only emulate her for a year because the next year my voice dropped. I adored Whitney Houston. I thought it was amazing how she could captivate an audience, not just with her voice, but with her presence. But the greatest vocal and spiritual influence of my life, I think, has been Cece Winans. From the first time I heard her at the PTL Club to last week when I listened to something she did on YouTube, it always amazed me how you could feel the love of God that she has between her and the Lord and between her and the people of God. I thought of her as I wrote Taste and See, Overwhelmed, and my new song, Love Wins. Definitely Cece Winans.
People keep asking, how do we stop this? What's gonna happen with all the violence? Killing one another, unequal justice. There is no freedom. How do we fix it? All we gotta do is call on God, trust God, believe God, obey God, and hate will fail, love will win. So kind, God gave his only son to show us the light. Loving one another kills all darkness. Our blood's the same color. That's how we fix it. All we gotta do is call on
a worship song that has gotten me through tough times. Here we go with Fred Hammond again. It's Give Me a Clean Heart. That song, in situations where I have been hurt, in situations where I have done the hurting, that song is a song that I always go back to. It's based on Psalm 51. And, you know, is another passage that I read often. And again, it's just, you know, David's plea after he had done some mess. He's just, you know, praying and asking the Lord to cleanse him. And whatever you do, don't take your Holy Spirit from me. So I would definitely have to say, Give Me a Clean Heart by Fred Hammond. As I said, I can think of so many times where I have put that song on and just laid in the floor and cried when I've been upset, when I've been angry. Like I said, whether it was me that did a wrong or somebody had wronged me, that's a song that I can always go back to. I can always go back to, and it always puts me in the right frame of mind. It always turns me back to the Father. It always calms me. So that would be a song that, again, has gotten me through some tough times. To this day, I listen to that song all the time because it's just a powerful song.
Give me a clean heart to see you like I should, to walk the path that's right, do the things you would. Give me a clean heart and I will serve nobody but you. Give me a clean heart to lose the double mind. Believe it when you tell me everything will be just fine. Just lay your hands on me, Lord, and I will be brand new. Let the band play for two now. Give me a clean heart, a better one, I pray. Stay on the path that's right and stick with it all the way. Give me a clean heart and I will serve nobody but you. Give me a clean heart. I'm coming now to you to keep my heart from fainting. This is all I know to do. Just lay your hands on me, Lord, and I will be brand new. And I am calling out to you for strength exchange. I would gladly take your joy for my weakness. Give me a clean heart, and I will serve nobody but you. Chris, won't you play now? Won't you play now, now, now? come into my life with no change. Give me a clean heart, and I will serve nobody but you, nobody but you. And I am calling out to you for a strength exchange. I would gladly take your joy for my weakness. Give me a clean heart, and I will serve nobody but you. And I am a worshiping your brain and a holy name. I'm determined to have a life with no chains. Give me a clean heart, and I will serve nobody but you. Nobody but you, yeah. And I am calling out to you for strength and change. I would gladly take your joy for my weakness. Give me a clean heart, and I will serve nobody but you. Nobody but you, hey. Give me a clean heart, and I will serve nobody but you.
Hey, I would like to give a shout out to my daughter, Danica, my granddaughter, Kaylee, my mother, Georgia Mae Dancy. They call her Deucey. My brother, Tyrone, we call him Bay Bra. My sister, Laurice, we call her Reese Cup or Sweet Pea. Their family. Pastor Kevin, Lady Melissa, and my nickname used to be Boo Boo. Don't y'all call me that. Just call me Laverne, Vernie. Don't call me Muskrat. That was another one. Just call me Laverne. But call me for a meal. I'll be ready to eat. See y'all. Peace.
Hey, I'd like to say a special hey to Pastor Kevin Matthews and First Lady Melissa. We love you so much, and we are so proud of you and how you've held everything together since being here during the pandemic. I'd like to say hey to Pam and Paul, my family. I love you guys so much. Aunt Jessie, the Jones and Dashiell family, pillars of music in the DMV. The Shepherd's House music leadership team, you guys are absolutely amazing, on point all the time. I love you. And to my awesome husband, Marv Ellis, you light up my life, sweetie. I love you.
All we gotta do is call.